Vikramaditya again pulled Betal from the tree and started walking.
Okay, I'm going to tell you another story. Listen carefully. Many years ago, a king called Amarnath ruled Kalinga. He had an intelligent and capable minister called Jayakumar. Amarnath loved his subjects and was very generous.
I am very proud to serve a king like this, but I am worried about the treasury. We will be in a bad shape when we don't have enough treasure during the period of emergency. I have explained to the king so many times, but he is not responding.
One day,
let me leave this place.
In a midnight, he left Kalinga. One day, when he was walking along seashore,
what is this? I cannot believe my eyes.
A small island emerged from the bottom of the sea.
What? A golden tree? Its fruits are glittering all over. I should know about this.
Immediately, he swam and reached the island. There.
Oh, a beautiful girl. How is she?
Welcome. I am a Naga woman. Every day, I used to come to the surface as I love your world very much. I have heard about kings. I wish I could meet one.
I see.
Yes. Okay. Take how much ever gold you want from here. But see to that you use it for the good cause.
Jayakumar left the island with the collected gold and went back to his country.
My lord, I met a Naga woman. She gave me this gold. She eagerly wanted to meet the king.
If I meet her, my people will live in prosperity.
Immediately, both of them started their journey. Reached the seashore, the same island emerged as before.
Jayakumar, be here. I'll be back.
Amarnath reached the island. When the girl saw him, she said,
"Oh King, I have been captured and imprisoned here by a demon. The demon is demanding for a country to release me. That is the reason I wish to meet the king."
What a pity. No problem. I will give over my country.
I'm glad, King. To be honest, I'm a Naga princess. My wishes were to marry a king like you. From now on, you'll be the king of Nagas.
Both of them married and the island submerged. Jayakumar was waiting for many days. Since the king did not return, he killed himself.
Betal ended the story at this point.
Tell me, King, who is responsible for the minister's death?
Minister himself was responsible for his death. If he had not walked away from his duty, this instance would not have taken place. All this happened because of him, so he is responsible.
Correct answer, but bye-bye.
Vikramaditya followed Betal, who flew back to the tree.